three, two, one.
All right, so how do we start with this? Oh.
This is Looter Kings. It's a dungeon crawler where you play as a bunch of goblins, and the alleged selling points are that you can, like, can do mayhem because you're goblins, and you can steal money from other people's, even though I never figured out how to make that work. The actual unique things about this game are that there's a specific emote dedicated to the fact that your actually modeled goblin junk can be jiggled at the camera.
Well, and also you can stack on other goblins.
Okay, yes, you can also do totem pole stacking, but seriously.
Man, talk about a goblin boomstick. Hey, gobby boom. Gobby net break.
So you might be noticing some hesitation in our voices. All right, so that's because Looter Kings is a bad game. I'm like, one of the shittier games we've played this year. Not gonna lie.
And yeah, it's pretty badly optimized. The control is weird. There's no controller support, even though it seems like a game that would be good for that. Or at least if there is, we couldn't find it. It has ranged weapons as one of the two, like, main options you start with, or you can get right at the beginning, but there's no, like, it's aim with a mouse and click and stuff, but you can't see where you're aiming at.
There's no reticle.
Problematic. Yeah. Nope. And the camera gets wonky when you're using melee weapons sometimes because you're trying to click on the enemy, but your mouse movements also control the camera.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it seems like if this game had a bit more, well, not more than a bit, you know, it needed polish. Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah, there is an interesting idea here. I mean, this game reminds me a lot of the Pathfinder tabletop role-playing game has about every other year for Free RPG Day been running a series of modules called We Be Goblins, where you play as some goblins in a tribe and do wacky goblin stuff with no moral repercussions because you're goblins. It feels like it wants to be that, but the fact that it's just a dungeon crawler where the only objective in any room is kill all the guys without getting killed, and the wonky controls and poor optimization and stuff really hold it back from what it wants to be.
Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, there's no sugarcoating it here. And keep in mind, we played about, what, an hour and a half of this?
Something like that.
We did three runs, I think. The first run, we all died horribly before we even got to a boss. The second run, we died horribly to a boss. And the third run, we got to a boss, actually managed to beat it, and then died.
Well, we got a little bit farther the third run.
Yeah. We were making progress. It's just nobody was enjoying the game enough to wanted to do anything else other than play Looter Kings.
Yeah. Each character, you can do parties of up to four. You can play with less, and there is an online lobby thing where you can make public lobbies and people can join and stuff. But yeah, each player has, as far as I could tell, a randomly generated god power, which there is one that makes a stone wall, there's one that makes you invisible, there's one that turns your skin to metal and gives you more defense.
There's one that makes like a clone of you and it will go auto attack.
Mm-hmm. That's sort of unique, I guess, and There's and the teamwork, it is teamwork oriented, because when one of your party members dies, one of your other team members has to go over and stand over them for a little while and revive them, which is important because this is a game that has permadeath on some difficulties, most difficulties, I think. So, yeah. You don't want to have everybody die because then you don't get to keep anything when you die. Yeah. I think you still get, like, to start the next run with a little bit more gold, which means maybe you can buy a better weapon, but you also have to unlock better weapons by beating bosses.
Yeah.
Like, you start out the game with literally toy wooden sword and literally toy crossbow.
Mm-hmm.
And then when we beat the boss, I got a real crossbow, and I think one of you guys got a real sword.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah. It's like three or four times as powerful, but still not very. It feels like this game might actually be fun after you play it a lot and get some clothes, because you do start out completely naked. There are apparently a lot of humorous clothing options in the game, but you have to unlock them and then buy them. Also, I think when you buy an item, if you want to switch to a different item, you may have to buy it again, although I could be wrong and I might have just forgotten dying in between.
Yeah.
Because I think you also are randomly assigned to start out with a sword or a crossbow.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think we mentioned why the ranged attacks suck. The melee attacks suck because there is no targeting.
Yeah.
No targeting at all, and I don't know why game developers continue to not have this as a thing.
Yeah, if you click the mouse button, you swing your sword, and I think it's sort of targeted on the thing that you're facing, mostly, but...
Yeah, I'm like, because... It's really hard to hit your opponent with a sword, because, the camera is shit.
Yeah, I think that's most of the problem with it, is just the camera difficulties, because, like...
Yeah.
There are some games that don't have lock on, but I do just fine them because the camera's not total ass.
Yeah, every weapon does have a special attack, which varies more than by every type of weapon, because the first crossbow has just sort of a slightly more powerful shot, and the upgraded one I got has like a triple shot.
A triple explodey shot.
Yeah. But I don't know what else, because I didn't get to unlock any other weapons. There are also several other weapon types. There's like a dual dagger weapon type. There's an axe weapon type. There was like a magic weapon type, I think.
Yeah.
And then, like I said, also there were humorous clothing and hat options. There are no pants options, I think, because, I mean, what's the fun in modeling a goblin's dick if you don't get to, like, have it hang out? Yeah,
this game has a lot of potential.
Kind of generous to this game because it has ideas, mm-hmm. and could be fun, like either if you suffer through playing enough to get powerful enough that the game's downsides don't hamper you as much, like if you could kill enemies faster, the fact that it's harder to stay focused on an enemy for a long time would be less of an issue.
I feel the same way. It's got potential, but it's just dragged down by the issues.
Yeah.
And that's aside from the performance issues, where, like, sometimes the camera will glitch out, or the game will, like, drop a few frames, then when it comes back, the camera will swing around to another completely ridiculous position that you wouldn't have wanted it in. Or it took, like, 5 minutes to load on my computer. I'm not even kidding. I mean, I know my computer isn't great, but...
Yeah, this game isn't exactly pushing the limits of 4K gaming.
Mm-hmm.
Also, sometimes you get weird obstacles, like, that I mean, it's random. It's procedurally generated dungeons, aside from the opening area, which another issue that we had issues with is that scattered throughout the opening area are a bunch of question marks that if you walk up to them, you get a tutorial dialogue box. These don't stop appearing after you've played the game for a while. Would have been nice if they did. Especially since some of them are like in front of doors and stuff. But yeah, one time when I was trying it out on my own before we played together, there's also no real single player in this. You can like go in with in a server with just yourself, but
you will be destroyed.
It works about as well as you'd expect for going into a challenge that you're intended for four people.
That's also why we're showing out trailer footage instead of the game, because there's no way to set up single player, because the game is literally not designed for single player.
Yeah, and if we were all playing it together, well, my computer probably couldn't take it, and also there were some problems with that. It did not always sync properly between. I mean, it wasn't terrible. It wasn't as bad as some of the games we've played, but sometimes people would get lost temporarily.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And, like, I guess it should be something of note is this game does have a Twitch mode. So, like,
where
if you have a bunch of...
with your Twitch community?
Yeah. Where basically they can, like, cast votes in the chat and whatnot for, like, what buffs and debuffs befall you.
Well, that's a cool idea. Again, the game has cool ideas.
Yeah, like, again, this would be really one of those, you know, if the controls were better, we could have a lot more fun with this.
Yeah, it's not the ideas that are the problem, it's the execution.
Yeah, the ideas in the game are honestly pretty great.
Yeah.
It's just the actual game part is the problem.
Yeah, it's like, no amount of good
ideas... Goblin Mayhem is a genre that there is openings in.
It's just this game isn't really going to fill that void. Unless you like falling into fire pits because the camera moved upwards.
Mm-hmm.
Or just because there's a big old fire pit in the first room that doesn't look like it's wide enough or doesn't look like it's narrow enough for you to jump over, but it is if you run right up to the edge before you jump.
Yeah, like I didn't have as much issues with the camera, but as soon as I let go of the mouse, it just, like, wanted to whip around wildly.
Yeah, mine does that, and also mine did that whenever it dropped a couple frames, like I said. And also, I'm bad at WASD, but I don't think it's just me that found the control scheme slightly awkward.
Like... I think the main issue isn't really as much the control as it is the camera fighting against you.
Yeah.
And I mean, Adam kept having trouble having trouble getting the shop window to open.
Yeah. I think that might have been a server thing, though.
Maybe.
There were all sorts of problems.
Yeah, like we mentioned, this game has some netcode issues that need to be ironed out.
Like my experience playing this, Adam seemed like he was really frustrated. My experience playing this was not that unpleasant. It was just,
I think I, my mouse sensitivity was way high or something.
Yeah. Pro tip: turn down your mouse sensitivity.
Because that just made everything amplified.
Yeah. Like, I usually play with my mouse sensitivity a little low, so that might have been the reason why I wasn't, you know, wanting to break my mouse in half.
Let's see. The game is currently $17.99. Doesn't really matter, because right now I couldn't recommend this game at any price. Yeah.
It needs some fixes before even looking at it.
Yeah.
Give us a reticle and give us better camera, and I would say it'd probably be worth it at that price. But until then, no, just keep an eye on it.
If they do several patches and improvements, I'll be interested in this maybe.
Yeah.
So, terms of numerical ratings, 4 out of 10, like below average, it's not apocalyptically bad or anything like that paintball game played not too long ago.
Yeah, this one actually shows promise. The paintball game was just very low effort.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and this does, like, mostly function. It doesn't function well. Like, it functions enough that you can see what it's trying to do, at least.
Yeah. So, with that in mind, I believe this will conclude this session of the Fragments of Silicon Reviews. And coming up in the week ahead, let's see, on MSP, it's
You really drowned out there, Adam. What happened?
Somebody seemed like there was a bit of wind there.
Yeah.
Anyway, the week ahead on MSP.
Currently, we don't have a guest. I've put some feelers out, but I'm waiting for them to get back to me.
Yeah. Not for nothing, you're going to have to step up on that because after next week, we don't have any guests, and you know, I don't want Mac bellowing to me about that again.
Yeah, I'm working on someone, but I'm waiting for them to respond.
So anyway, Mac has somebody in mind for this week. I don't remember who.
It was one of the voice actors, I think, that he wanted to work with.
Yeah.
Wanted to do a show with.
I'm like... Not sure when we're going to get an update on that. Also worth noting, we do not have a Tuesday interview slated for this week. Just the one show. And joining us for, his 9th, possibly 10th time on the program. The current all-time record holder interview.
Better be careful, Adam. If you don't, we're going to run out of fingers soon.
There are still toes. Anyway.
Fair enough.
Getting back to what I was saying, this Wednesday, we're welcoming John Pickett of Manga Gamer back to the program. No specific visual novel this time, mainly because they just announced a whole bunch of stuff that, whatever the recent anime convention was, like last week or so.
I think Otakon was recently.
Yeah, I want to say Otakon, but I'm not 100% on that. The point is, they made a whole bunch of announcements, and we're going to be talking about that. Let's see. And coming up next week, as far as reviews go, currently we have Morio Chronic, like the latest from Idea Factory. Like, I cannot guarantee that streaming will not be involved with this.
Soft crying can be heard from the stream operator.
Yes, because you have the other copy of this game.
Yeah.
And our other review will be Nidhogg 2. Like
something that actually looks fun.
Yeah, I'm like, and we'll probably get where you and I are, Petty Fan, are going to look at this on Friday.
All right.
Now, because it is Nidhogg, so it's pretty multiplayer focused.
Oh, that's expensive.
Yes, it is. I mentioned.
Now what's the other game called? Morio?
Morio, like Moe Rio.
Fun Moe, fact, our like, review schedule is on the TalkShoe site.
Chronicle?
Yeah, Morio Chronic or Chronicle, however you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Chronicle? Probably.
Regardless, I'm still terrified when the word Idea Factory gets brought up. You know what they've done.
But you have to recruit monster girls to save the world in this Moe-filled dungeon RPG.
Oh, please, like, God.
Yeah, I'm like, this is... Yeah, it's like... You might want to prepare a sitz bath.
I might want to prepare some alcohol.
I something. Like, it's brushing up against Idea Factory's usual proclivities. You know, there's a complicated word to say.
So,
yeah. Not super interested in Nidhogg aesthetically, but at least the original at least looked fun to play, so.
Yeah. Anyway, so that is the week ahead.
And until Wednesday, I shall wish you good gaming.